Phil, the ending push out Phil on Tall Tall Trees is like this. Left, right, right, left, right, right, right. Okay, so you're going to push with your right hand and with your foot to accent that down on the bottom too. Okay, so it's, this is it in real time. Two, three, four. Okay, a little slower would be... Left, right, right, left, right, right, right. You push with your foot the whole time you're pushing with your hand. Snare, hi-hat, snare, hi-hat. Snare, hi-hat, snare, hi-hat, crash, crash. Okay, that's that ending feel. So here it is on the record. Right, okay, and that in one of them for sure, like the one before the accordion was a definite kick snare, right? The other ones might just be kind of a harder stop, just a, you know.
Can you go over that really big fill that?
Yeah, okay.
Slower.
Okay, that's before the chorus, ba-da-da-da-da-da-da. But when you speed that up, that rhythm, it turns into, I guess, 16th notes. So you're grooving along. It's almost like a little pause kind of thing he did before the fill. It's a lengthy kind of thing. So. See, it's like you're stopping the groove altogether to really emphasize that big fill, you know? Because the bass drum's laying out for two or three beats or so, you know. So watch my foot. It's not going to play when I stop the main part. Right? Until I come back in on the downbeat on that one to go to a crash. One, two. You know, it's almost like it's its own thing because you're stopping the groove in a way to do this bigger fill. Okay, so that's the biggest one to remember. Let's see if I go through all the fills first. So in the intro, before the or coming out of the intro before the first verse was, right? One, two, three, third verse. Okay. And then we're at the chorus, so that would be that big one I explained before. Or like this. Kind of staying on the snare longer. Okay. And then before the solo was pop pop pop. I think. No, it's more than that. Not that either. I think it's. So you're here. Yeah, that seems to be common. Like then he follows a lot of his hand fills up with a at the end of the right kind of thing. So that was that one. That was right before the solo fiddle. Remember the solo's three part, so fiddle, lead guitar, steel. Now right after that fiddle solo, how many ever bars it is, was another little quick that you nailed, right? So that was pretty easy. He didn't want to put a big one there, so he just threw in a little quick one because you're transitioning from two different instruments. Okay, so that gets us at the lead guitar part, and then we're going to go into a steel solo to end the whole solo section out, and there wasn't anything getting into the steel. It was fluid, I believe. Okay, but at the end of the steel solo to go into the next verse was kind of like going back to the intro, which was that... Okay. And then verse, and then you got that big accordion breakdown, which was a right? And then back in with the accent down, right? When I'm using my left hand, really start using yours too, and don't rely so much on this one. So that was very huge. Okay. And that leads us to the end big fill, push section fill out, which was a... left, right, right, left, right, right, right. And that's it. Yeah. From the top to there is how it's going to go. Before the solo was, okay, so I'll back it up. We stopped at the solo, and I'll do that fill he did right before the solo happens. Solo's two parts. Fiddle took the first part, then the guitar then lost that fill. Here comes the guitar. There's a little right there, right? Just a little accent-y thing, because you're going from fiddle guitar. Okay, so let me go back to that whole before the solo. Play through everything now. It was three solos: fiddle, lead guitar, steel. Okay, so you see how it separated it, you know? Okay, and then it went back to that fill he did before, which was in the intro, kind of bringing it back down to a verse. Okay, so let me back that up. Similar. That was that same one again before the other break again, right? Okay, so let me back that up.
Over you before you talk it.
I think that, so the first one I think was, see if I'm right. It is, because that's where we stopped the last, a second ago, yeah.
Tall trees and all.
Up on me. So we're kind of going back to the accordion Cajun-y feel. So that's kind of what's happening so far. So yeah, breaks.
Boy, I tall, tall trees and all the waters in the seas. I'm a fool, fool, fool for you.
Two, three, four. That's what he did. Probably on all of them. Instead of just, I don't know. But anyway, it's a break. Okay, so another solo, right? But we're going to kind of turn it around and go back to the intro thing, and then we're going to be out, okay? So let's see.
Yeah, I'm a fool, fool, fool for you.
That's Eddie Bear's for sure, because that's all a lot of George Strait stuff. Okay, so.
Fool, he's that money you want, well.
Push out kind of quick. Or in real time. Okay, so it turns back around. Now let me see if I can remember all that and play the whole thing the whole way.
Thank you.
that end a little bit, but that's how it goes.
Sure, I got it.
it's